He finished it. He could sit down because he was finished. He said on the cross, "It is finished." Love's redeeming work was done once and for all. That is why Jesus is a superior priest. He sat down, and notice where he sat down. He sat down at the right hand of God the Father. Now, the right hand of a throne, of a monarch or a judge, was the place of authority, equal authority. And that may be the significance of saying that Jesus sat down at the right hand of God the Father. But pastor and Bible teacher John MacArthur offers another possible interpretation of this. He notes that the Sanhedrin, which was the ruling council of the Jews, it was kind of the Supreme Court of the Jews. There were 70 elders who were a part of this court, the Sanhedrin. The presiding judge would sit in the middle. And on either side, the left and the right, there were secretaries. If a person was found guilty by the Sanhedrin, the secretary on the left was in charge of writing out the sentence, the condemnation. But the secretary on the right was in charge of writing out acquittals. If the person was found guilty, the secretary on the left wrote out his condemnation. If he was declared not guilty, it was the person on the right who wrote out the acquittal. Jesus Christ is seated where? Not on the left hand to write out our condemnation, but to sit on the right hand to write out our forgiveness, our acquittal. Isn't that what Jesus said in John chapter 3? We all know verse 16. For God so loved the world that he sent his only begotten Son, that whoever believes, trusts in, clings to him, shall not perish, but shall have eternal life. But remember what verses 17 and 18 say? Jesus continued by saying, for God did not send his Son into the world to judge the world, but that the world through him might be saved. People say, Jesus doesn't judge anybody. See, preacher, why are you so judgmental? I mean, Jesus doesn't judge people. He didn't go around calling people sinners. He just came to forgive people. He didn't judge anybody. Go on to what he said in verse 18. Because Jesus went on to say, for he who believes in the Son is not judged. But he who does not believe in the Son of God is judged already. Because he has not believed in the holy begotten name of the Son of God. You see, Jesus doesn't have to judge anybody because we're already condemned. We are born into this world guilty, the Bible says. For all have sinned and fallen short in the glory of God. The Bible says we've already been judged from the moment we drew our first breath in this world. We are born separate from God. That means we are all declared guilty. We are like prisoners on death row awaiting our final execution. But Jesus offers us one last chance. He says, if you will trust in me for the forgiveness of your sins, I will commute your sentence. I will take that guilty verdict and change it into a not guilty verdict, and you can have eternal life. That's what the job of the Son of God is. He sits on the right hand of God the Father, ready to forgive anyone who asks him for forgiveness. Jesus Christ completed his work.